starts moaning, oh, come on, come on. So, you know, okay. No, you can't, because I'm right. So, look, we are a better team with him on the pitch than we are off it, that's for sure.
Thanks.
So,
with
regards to preparation for the Asian Cup, how satisfactory was it to you?
Very. I think even in the first press conference, we talked about this, that we and our boys, everyone, of course, wanted to win this tournament, but you know, we say football, the peripheral vision is about Asian Cup. Everything that we do is going to be about Asian Cup. And we'll try our best, not only here when we get affiliated in the national team, but also when we go back to the club. Everyone has a vision. Of course, they're going to do well when they play for their respective clubs, but Asian Cup is the thing. When I played in 2011, I know how important it is for the country and how big it is. And I'm just trying to tell the boys each and every day with whichever way possible that how big it is. So make sure when they come over there, at the end, we should have a feeling that, you know what, this we should have done a little bit more, or that we should have done a little bit more. Once we finish the Asian Cup, the feeling should be, you know what, we gave each and everything that possible that we could, and it starts right from now. And small things like taking care of your diet, to taking care of your sleep, every inch that we can take as a player, and make sure when we come over there, we reach there, every one of us is well prepared.
Yes. Coach, successful tournament and some of the key players also, you know, performing good. So, are there still any areas of concern which you want to address? Or?
Look, there's always areas where we can get better and improve. I'd rather keep those to myself than share it. But look, we know we have a huge task going to the Asian Cup. We're not going there to make up the numbers. We believe that if we do the right things between now and then, we have a chance to qualify from this group. And that will be our target. And this tournament again gave us the opportunity to prepare as we would prepare in the Asian Cup. This game for us was, we made it to the last 16 in the Asian Cup, and this is what we can expect. These kind of games with, you know, opponents like Kenya. Okay, we won't face Kenya in the Asian Cup, but you will have teams that are a step or two above them, and they will be pushing us and pressing us, and we held on. And I'm not sure what would have happened if they would have scored with 15 minutes to go, but they didn't. And the character and the resilience of the team is what impressed me the most.
Yes, please.
Yeah.
So, Coach, though you are considered favourites, you have had a lot to explore and experiment about. How happy are you with the training and preparation, and how they've gone about? Because, you know, the positives, you know, they reflect on the field. So, how?
Look, I think having the camp here in Mumbai and the help of the people here in Andheri has been tremendous. Also, Aditya Thackeray is a huge supporter. So if we do have any issues, it's a phone call and it usually gets done pretty quick, which is why I like coming here. It's very important that we get the right atmosphere to prepare and. As you said, these games are vital for us.
Congratulations on the great day.
Thank you.
Coach, there are talks about moving forward, there are talks that the team might be involved in two friendlies apart from the Asian Games and the SAF Cup.
Yeah.
And then the gap which might or might not include a few friendlies before you land in UAE for the Asian Cup.
Okay, let me. There definitely will be two games in the camp before the Asian Cup. So that would be sometime in December. Okay, our first game is on January 6th. We will be looking to play 28, 29, somewhere about a week before our first game. That is going to happen.
The matches, you bring the camp as a game?
Yes. I can't tell you opponents at the moment, but I'm working on it. November, we are very close with an away game in Saudi. Again, this is not 100%, very close. October, we have one or two possibilities. September, because of the SAF tournament, obviously we have to participate in this. And then you have, in a month's time, we'll start preparation for the Asian Games. And thank you to the Olympic Committee for allowing us to go, because I think it's huge for the development of some of these boys that are here in this camp. We need those games, we need that exposure, and you know, I'm happy that they're allowing us to go.
Coach, question being, from your point of view, these many games were that good enough to prepare a game for Asia Cup?
Well, we don't really have too many choices. The league has to be played. I'm not for 6 months of camp, training, playing meaningless games. The players will be better off at their clubs, training hard and having that competitive games in the league. Obviously, we'd like to get the players on the 10th of December, which is what we're working for. That will give them players time to get used to the situation, and then we go to the camp for the Asian Cup.
Coach, one question to Sunil. Firstly, you always have said that there are a certain type of player that you look for your team. Would you be looking for more players in the coming week? And Sunil, so you kept on running throughout the match behind the ball even after having a 2-0 lead. Even at the 88th minute, you could see you running, chasing the ball. What gives you the motivation to continuously chase the ball and show the
capture? Kenya were really pushing us, so I had to run back. I've seen when, as a senior player, not as a captain, but as a senior player, when you do the hard work and come back and defend, it rubs in the right way to everyone, and I could see it. So sometimes JJ does that for me, sometimes Thapa does that for me. So seeing them run, you want to run. So one of the talks that we have is make sure there's no negativity, because each of the spreads, somebody puts their head down, they want to put their head down. So one thing that we really had a talk about each other is make sure that everyone is positive. And when it comes from a player like somebody senior, it rubs more. So I try to be as much an example as possible, and it just reciprocates to everyone. And sometimes when I'm down, JJ pulls me up, Thapa pulls me up, Pranoy pulls me up, they scream at me, which is great. And we just try to pull each other up, and it spreads. It's something which really spreads, and I just hope that we can continue.
Ask
your
question.
I
wanted to know that, would you be looking for more players that suit your style of the game in the coming league? And if yes, then what positions are you looking?
I'm always looking in all positions. I'm always looking. And we could see a player as a left back or as a right midfield player. If he ticks our boxes, then he has a chance. But there's a certain type of player, as I said before. So yes, I am looking.
Thank you very much.